Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to show you how to use StatCrunch to find the mean and standard deviation for a probability distribution, and also to answer questions like what's the probability that there will be greater than 2 or less than 2 or at least 4 or whatever they're asking you about that. So in this particular question, it's asking you, is this an actual probability distribution? And for that, we want to say that every trial is independent. We want to say that every value of P of X is numerical. We want to say that all the numerical values are less than 1 and add up in total to 1. So we can say, yes, that is a probability. I've already added that up. Okay. And then it's asking to find the mean and the standard deviation for this. And this is a population, so we're using mu and so sigma, because those are the population ones. So we're going to open this in StatCrunch. And we're going to click on Stat. See, it gives us our values here and our probabilities there. And so we're going to click on Stat and then Calculators and then Custom. And we want to say we want to use X as our value and P of X as our weight. And then we can just click Compute. And that is going to show us the mean of 2.5 and a standard deviation of 1.1 if we were rounding it, depending on where they ask us to round it. But also down here, notice this, we're saying what's the probability, this first one says, what's the probability that X is less than or equal to 2? And that means that it's at most 2, right? It can't be 3, 4, or 5, and it tells you that probability. What if we wanted to know what's the probability that we have exactly 2? That's 0.315. And you can see that in the chart up above. You probably wouldn't need to do those exact ones because they're given. What's the probability that we have no more than 1, something like that? Then that's less than or equal to 1. Whoop. Sorry, I shouldn't have hit 1 there. So that's 0.185. And if you look up here, that's the sum of the first and the second one, right? So these just is a way to use StatCrunch to answer those questions very quickly and easy and to find the mean and standard deviation. All right, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time.